Ghana is the second largest global producer of cocoa, which drives its economy, but is also one of the main causes of forest loss. Now, with an ambitious Red Plus program, Ghana is working to reduce emissions from deforestation and forest degradation across 6 million hectares of West Africa Guinean forest. It involves the entire cocoa supply chain, from farmers and local communities to private companies and government agencies. Together, they are working to transform farming practices and land use decisions to make the cocoa sector more socially, economically, and ecologically sustainable. For example, using shade trees, which helps produce healthier, more plentiful cocoa crops.
About 3 years ago, my farm was nothing to write home about. Then I decided to be part of the Red Plus initiative, and it has been a great journey. This year, my cocoa trees have given me more yields, and it is because of the shade trees I planted, and I am happy.
Ghana is not only measuring success by the increased number of cocoa beans produced, but also by the amount of carbon emissions reduced. The World Bank's Forest Carbon Partnership Facility, FCPF, is supporting Ghana's Red Plus program. This includes helping to develop systems for measuring, reporting, and verifying these emission reductions. This collective effort is paying off. In January 2023, Ghana received $4.8 million for reducing 972,000 tons of emissions, becoming the second country in Africa to receive results-based payments from the FCPF. The country is due to receive up to $50 million for the 10 million tons of emissions reduced by the end of 2024. A benefit-sharing plan ensures the bulk of these payments go to farmers and local communities that are helping to achieve results. Ghana is showing the world how to decarbonize a global commodity supply chain from the ground up.